We know that women, when they break through, we've seen with the ADG Awards, they can have success, but not enough women are breaking through. So what's going on? As I said, we've got two great female directors on the stage with us now. But first of all, I just want to come back to Jan and Troy, because I've found that women directors can be very modest in talking about themselves. So Troy, can you tell me a little about, just briefly, what you see as the strengths that female directors can have and offer?
Well, it really goes to the nature of the storytelling, and I think it's like anything else. If you're reading a novel or a painting or a piece of poetry, it's the female perspective gives you something different. And for us, you know, if we're assessing a very female-driven story and it's matched with a female director, then for us that's a positive thing, because we know that there's going to be a layer upon that that has a sort of sensibility that females are going to respond to. So I think it's, you know, and look, I'm speaking to a lot of actors who love being directed by women as well. So, yeah, I think it's, again, it's just a different perspective, a certain warmth of the storytelling, more character-driven. So, yeah, I think that's something that's very, very important.
And you mentioned that while the kind of traditional notion of a director is often associated with the characteristics of authority and assertion, you said that women are bringing other characteristics which are not part of the traditional package but can be really important. I think you mentioned emotionality and collaboration.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't see any stats for the production side, Australian producers as women, because I think that's a really key... I mean, I've had the great pleasure of working with some great female producers here in Australia, Jan, Michelle Benner, Rosemary Blight, just to name a few. And I think the reason why that proportion is so high is I think, especially in this country, the producer's role is actually very creative, much more so than I think in many other countries. And so a lot of that instinct for a producer comes out in that process. And so I think, you know, I also think that... I don't know what I'm thinking at the moment. I've just kind of lost my train of thought.
We want to talk about collaboration, because you just said that directors after can be collaborative during the shoot and also after the shoot, which in getting feedback and dealing with feedback.
Yeah, I think that, look, again, it's very anecdotal, but the experiences I've had with people like Cate is a much more collaborative process in the post-production. And also, again, because you're dealing with great female producers, I think that, you know, the role is very nurturing. Mm. It's a very nurturing environment with a female producer. And so you seem to have an experience where it encourages teamwork. Whereas, you know, again, you know, when you're dealing with male directors, a lot of the time it's really their call. Everything's it's sort of like a pyramid structure.
Yes.
And everything's around the decisions they make. Well, it's very general, but with the experience I've had in this country, the collaboration is much more creative and a lot more collaborative.
And Jan, what about you? What are the qualities you've seen in female directors? And I know everyone is an individual, but have you seen any qualities that female directors can have that can really work for them?
Yeah, I would say that with every woman I've worked with as a director, her preparation and attention to detail and determination to get the whole thing right before she starts has been extraordinary. A little more detailed, a little more concentrated maybe than the men generally, and I am generalising, but astoundingly, they will work to not only get the script to a point that they really believe is correct, they're willing to go back and do further and further drafts, but also they want to work with the DOP and they want a storyboard and they want to work with a designer and really spend a lot of time in that preparation, which I do believe is one of the most important things in making a really good film. I would agree with Troy that obviously collaboration, I mean, it's fun working with other women. They like to talk about... they like your opinion. I mean, why be a producer if you're not allowed to be part of the creative process? I mean, I do think it's true that there are more women producers in Australia who are truly creative. And you know, why not? But it's generally a very equal and collaborative and creative process working with women directors.
And we're also here today, we also said we'd take responsibility and look at the things that women can do themselves. So are there qualities that cannot work for female directors that you've seen or observed? Perhaps not in the female directors you've worked with, but other directors in the industry.
I think they're sensitive to criticism. hard on themselves, a little hard on themselves sometimes. And this kind of attention to detail may often mean that it takes longer to do another film because they want to get the next one right as well.
Is that something which is an issue? Do female directors sometimes have less momentum in their careers? Because certainly when I've looked at the Australian directors who've done 4 and 5 films, a lot of them are men, and a lot of them seem to have got their next film financed before the previous film was released, and they have a slate and they're moving quite forward. Can that be an issue for women, momentum in their careers?
I think the second film syndrome is something that does affect both men and women, mm-hmm. I must say. I generally think that women tend to take longer to get their work ready, mm-hmm. but I think that's because they want to get it right.